Hey everyone, my name is Root and we are here. This is going to be week number 7 of the PGBL up against our rival Spparows and the New England Evolutions. Now he's having an incredibly good season, which is really, really scary. And in all honesty, I built a pretty darn risky team against him, but I do really like my team when it's all said and done. It's just, I don't know how well it's going to match up. I think I have a solid beat on what he's going to bring. I think he's going to bring the Crest, the Koma-O, the Manectric, the Nidoking, the Carton, and the Gastrodon. Now, I could definitely see his Arcanine coming and taking up one of those slots. I think if the Arcanine comes, the Gastrodon is less likely to come. Like I said, my team is really darn risky. I do have a Scarfed Tapu Fini this week. This is my first time trying to go offensive with my Tapu Fini, but I just think it matches up pretty darn well against his team. I'm gonna have to see just what we can do there. Let's see how correct my predictions were. Let's see how well this Fini is gonna match up. I think this Fini can punch holes, but I definitely think that my Shaman can be the one to really punch the most holes. Okay, so we see the Manectric, Arcanine, Mandibuzz, Kartana, MIMIKYU, and Gastrodon. So no Nidoking straight off the bat. No Cress, which is nuts. No Cress is bananas. Okay, either way, it's totally fine. No Koma-O as well. I was super concerned about the Koma-O. And my Shaman set is going to be a lot less helpful because my Shaman is actually Kebbia Berry for the Nidoking or the Koma-O, neither of which are apparently going to come. Either way, we can deal with this. I think the best lead might just be the Fini. Also, no Shuckle, which is pretty darn huge as well. Maybe I could lead the Necrozma? He doesn't have a Rock Setter, does he? He doesn't. I'm going to lead the Fini. Once again, running out of time, as I do. I honestly kind of want to just lead off with my Infernape as well and just kind of U-turn out on whatever matchup is there, but I think Fini can get some initial damage off. I think a turn one Moonblast is going to do work to whatever he decides to bring out. But let's just see. I did unfortunately have to make my Fini timid, which is really unfortunate because if I was just max speed modest, then I actually speed tie with the Manectric with the Scarf. So I had to make it timid, which I was really upset about. I was really hoping I could put in a lot of work with the Fini. Now, I think a Moonblast is pretty much free. I think his best switch in would be the Gastrodon. Let's see. Theoretically, it doesn't really matter. I have to click Moonblast no matter what. But it should be doing about 40-ish percent. I'm just gonna click it. Does withdraw. Maybe I should have just clicked Toxic. There's the Gastrodon. It should do about 40-ish percent, assuming max HP, unless you're super specially defensive as well. Ugh, let's see. Let's give this max special defense. ...26 to 32%. Yeah, that's specially defensive. But I don't know what you do to me in return. I feel like I can just Moonblast again. I do get off another Moonblast. No leftovers as well. Drop special attack. Mirror coat. Okay. All right, I see you. Well, I do want to save this Fini. For later. I'm thinking that the best play would be to go into my Infernape right now. I could also just go into Metagross. If I go into my Shaman, then a Seed Flare would be so free. However, he would know that, and that would let me, that would allow me to get up a Tailwind. I have Tailwind on my Shaymin, BT dubs. So Shaymin with a Tailwind, I believe I made my Shaymin. Yeah, I made it a decently fast Shaymin so I can outspeed a Scarfed Kartana. And I have a chance to Oko, but that's only with rocks up. Maybe I shouldn't do that. You know what? I'm gonna go for it. I don't think he makes an aggressive double here. I don't. I'm not sure what he does. Because he goes for the recover. That's totally fine. But I can now get up a Tailwind. What would be a switch? And a switch in would be Arcanine, maybe? That might be worth a double, actually. Arcanine would be the obvious switch, but going into Necrozma and getting rocks up now would be pretty huge. I think I should do that. Grand scheme of things, I should probably do that. But yeah, Mirror Coat Gastrodon is kind of wild. Goes for the withdrawal. I don't know what this is. Mandibuzz. I don't mind this. He could defog. He could defog my rocks, but you know what? I can toxic him right now. This seems worth it if I can get a toxic off. He might knock me off right now. He might knock me off. I think I have leftovers, if I'm not mistaken. But yeah, he can see that I'm very, very defensive. I did have to forego sub on this, which is super unfortunate because now he can toxic me pretty freely. And I can't touch this thing, actually. I really can't. So maybe I should just set up rocks. He's gonna try to toxic me, which I guess is fine. Would there be a worthy switch out? I guess Metagross is a switch out, kind of. Well, no, the play would always be to get a rocks first. Goes for the withdrawal. Goes into the Mimikyu. However, this Photon Geyser, so I'm a really defensive Necrozma, right? And this Photon Geyser should ignore Disguise. So I guess we're gonna see how this works. Although I do wanna see Mimikyu. I should be doing over half to this thing and I should ignore Disguise, I believe. Goes for the Swords Dance. Man, I don't know. I'm Prism Armor and I'm really defensive. There's the Photon Geyser. Yes, okay. Okay. I'm gonna have to just trust that I can take a hit here. Maybe Q could tear through my team, but I'm gonna have to trust that I can take a hit here. I don't think this is Z-Mon either. I don't know, man. I have to just take a hit. I'm a bold Necrozma. 228 defense, 228 HP. Drain Punch. Interesting. Just trying to get some HP back. But that's not gonna get you nearly enough HP. Oh, maybe it does. Oh no. Oh, the Life Orb. Okay, good. Mimikyu is a huge, huge threat out of the way. That is a huge, huge threat out of the way. I am so excited. Okay, I'm feeling pretty good right now. Okay. Okay. So what does this mean now? He might go into Mandibuzz. No, I was gonna say he might go into Mandibuzz for the defog, but no. Okay, so how well are we taking Manectric? How well are we taking a Thunderbolt? UU all-out attacker. At level 50, like I said, we're pretty darn bulky. We should actually take a Thunderbolt fine. I don't really need Necrozma for anything. I mean, it would be really nice against the Arcanine. I actually might be able to Moonlight as well. He could honestly just be Volt Switching to put me in range of a Kartana, so that Kartana can just sweep from there. That would be interesting. From what I can see, I really don't think a Moonlight or a Thunderbolt is going to do over half to me. I'm going to click Moonlight. I'm going to click Moonlight, unless he has some kind of like crazy heat that I'm not aware of. Oh, this is a timid Manectric that I'm looking at. I guess Modest might take me out. Oof. I guess we just see. There's a Thunderbolt. Okay. Awesome. We were at 113. We go from 113 to 17. And we go up to 117. Yikes. Okay. I think no matter what, this thing goes down right now. But I think getting that damage off with Photon Geyser would be really worth it right now. Unless there's a worthy switch in right now, and I don't think there is. I just don't think there is. Unless I try to make the big boy call and go into Zygarde. Actually, a Photon Geyser would put the Manectric in range of... Extreme Siege from Zygarde, which could scare it out. Let me get a Dragon Dance up. That would be super interesting. But ultimately, it might be too early for that. I could click Photon Geyser, but he does have the obvious switch into Mandibuzz, but that doesn't really threaten me because I can Moonlight up on that. Might as well just click Photon Geyser. Goes for the Volt Switch. I feel like he sees me staying in, so he might go into the Mandibuzz, but Mandibuzz is a very free Moonlight for me. Goes into Arcanine. I'm gonna get intimidated, totally fine. And I'm going to be able to judge some damage based off of... Oh, that is right around 50%. Okay, that's super interesting. 50% might mean no bulk at all. If I give it max HP, I think... Okay, it's a roll. So it could actually be max HP or no investment at all. So not really helpful. If I had to guess, it's probably bulky, right? Necrozma is definitely worth saving. He's got extreme speed, I feel like. Necrozma's worth saving. Only because of that Mandibuzz. If that Mandibuzz wasn't there, then I would say maybe not, but... And I could Toxic the Gastrodon as well. Oh, I never took a screenshot of the team. Oh, that sucks. I'm upset with myself. I'm also really considering just going into Zygarde here. You would have to be banded to take out my Zygarde. And then I band hit you back. I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna go into Zygarde here. This might not be worth it. Because ultimately Zygarde healthy is a lot more valuable than... In the long run, it's a lot more valuable than my Necrozma would be. Ah, that does over half. Okay. But I can extreme speed you back. And I think he has to assume that I'm banded at this point. Yeah, there's no planet on which you should be able to take an extreme speed. Unless you're max defense. Actually, does that extreme speed damage tell me anything about offensive investment? It actually means that you're offensive. This is an offensive Arcanine. But yeah, I don't think he saves Arcanine at all because he withdraws. He withdraws. Interesting. So I might be able to take this thing out. Let's see. Mandibuzz. Does an outrage take you out? Oh, an outrage might take you out. But wait, I saw extreme speed do about 25%. Yeah. Outrage probably takes you out. I'm gonna go for it. I'm gonna click outrage. If we can take out this Mandibuzz right now, that'd be pretty darn huge. And it's unfortunate to have to give up my Zygarde for like right now, but I think it's absolutely worth it if I can get this outrage off. There's the outrage. Oh, we don't. Okay. That's unfortunate. Just goes for the roost. And that's going to give them the free switch in to anything he wants right now. I think I misjudged because it had some prior damage on it and then it took some rocks damage. Yeah, I think I just misjudged the damage. But no matter what, if it does stay in and take out my Zygarde, then it's going to do that at the expense of possibly its Mandibuzz because the poison damage is going to rack up. You have to like foul play me right now. I don't think you can just like roost all me. He is going to try to roost all me. A toxic is going to rack up. And I think that's a three turn. I think that's a two turn outrage. Or no, sorry. A three turn outrage is what I meant to say. Toxic, bring him below half. Oh. Okay, that sucks. And is that... Yeah, it's three turn outrage, so I can't even do anything. I literally can't even click a button. I made a mistake. This is a max defense Mandibuzz. I 100% made a mistake, and now I'm kind of locked into this mistake for three turns. But this, if he roost stalls, then he's not going to be able to defog away these rocks, which is also going to be pretty huge. Just go for the roost. He's gonna fall below half. He's going to fall below half. Which should... That's super close to outrage range. But if I switch out, that gives him a free roost. But if he does take that free roost, then he's gonna take a decent amount of poison damage. And it's going to put me in a position to set up a little bit. Okay, let me think this through. I feel like the best play might just be to outrage again. But is it though? Yeah, I think I just click outrage. I just click outrage. And maybe we take this thing out, maybe we don't. We just missed it out. Okay, fair enough. Fair enough. Goes for the defog. And it fails because I took myself out. And he's gonna take himself out to toxic. Oh man, that is a wild turn of events. Okay, that's actually insane. Okay, now we both get free switches. See, part of me feels like he brings in... Gastrodon. to see what I want to bring out. But I can also definitely see him bringing out the Manectric. I want to bring out the Infernape, but if he brings out the Manectric, then that's genuinely pretty bad. I feel like that means I have to bring out the Feeny. Okay, good. This is perfect. He's gonna think that he has an opportunity to outspeed me and just take me out with a Volt Switch, or he actually thinks he has the freest Volt Switch right now. He definitely thinks he has the freest Volt Switch possible right now. But Feeny Moonblast is about 60%, and that's going to put him in range. That's probably going to put him in range of a Vacuum Wave from my Infernape. Let me see. What's Infernape doing with the Vacuum Wave? Ooh, okay. With another set of rocks, then probably. I just clicked Moonblast. Here's where we reveal Scarf. There we go. All right. Beautiful damage, and a special attack drop. Goes for the Thunderbolt. That's totally fine. So here's the thing, right? If I bring out the... No, there's no other option. I have to bring out the Infernape. And the Infernape's going to make it super obvious that I am... He's going to think that I'm Scarfed. Definitely. 100% he's going to think that I'm Scarfed. But I'm not. Gastrodon would be the obvious switch in, but Gastrodon goes down to a Grass Knot. He could bring in the Kartana, but Kartana also goes down to a Grass Knot. And this thing is this actual game? Is this game? I guess there's no use in not going for Vacuum Wave then. I just click Vacuum Wave. Oh, but we've already determined that's a very specially defensive Gastrodon, so it's not going to be as simple as just clicking Grass Knot and winning the game. So I actually have to see what damage I'm outputting. Actually, no, this is totally fine. This is totally fine because he's going to think that he takes a Grass Knot and hits me back with a Miracoat. But yeah, no, I don't think there's any way that I take this thing out. If I give this thing max special defense, yeah, no, there's no way. So here's the thing, right? It's somewhat of a trap because now I can go into my Shaymin, which means that He's gonna fire off a Scald, and I'm gonna get a free Tailwind. If he decides to go into his Kartana right now, then that gives me a free Tailwind, and I can Earth Power possibly for a KO. Even if the Kartana is Scarfed, I can still just Earth Power. Oh, does he think he can take a Seed Flare? Can he take a Seed Flare? Oh, Rindoberry, he can take a Seed Flare. I have to weaken him with Earth Power. I might as well just click Earth Power and try to weaken this Gastrodon. Yeah, that should be enough damage where Seed Flare... Oh, okay. Tectonic Rage. I don't think this does anywhere near enough damage. So it's not Rindoberry, which means I could have clicked Seed Flare at any time. But I don't think this matters. Because here's the thing, I'm like, the tailwind is going to be up enough where I can get a hit off on Cartana. And even if not, then Infernape comes in and clicks Vacuum Wave. Unless he avoids. I might have to click Tailwind again. This is last turn of Tailwind. Okay, this is bad, actually. If he switches right now, then that's actually pretty bad. Although, I could click Earth Power. No, I can't click Earth Power. It doesn't matter. Infernape cleans up. I have to remind myself, Infernape cleans up. This is the last turn of Tailwind. But it shouldn't matter unless the Cartana is Chobbleberry. Although, that really does suck, because Shaman could have won me the game right here. But this is exactly the matchup that I wanted. Infernape Vacuum Wave, without any investment into a Cartana, it should do 133% to this thing. So I just click Earth Power. Maybe it doesn't have anything that can KO right now. Okay, we take that. Earth Power has a chance to KO. There we go. Okay, we do get the 4-0. That was pretty huge because I did genuinely want the 4-0 instead of the 3-0. We do pick up the win against Spparows. That was... Oh, I completely forgot this thing existed. It goes down to rocks. No, it doesn't. Never mind. I 100% forgot that this was a thing. It's going to be able to take me out. But... It's fine. I just click Earth Power. I guess the 3-0 is going to happen no matter what. It's fine. I don't think he can even afford... No, I think he wanted to go for a Morning Sun because I think he knew that that was the only opportunity. Because if he didn't go for a Morning Sun, then my Metagross wins. Because he would take himself out to recoil. So I don't... Unless he was like Flamethrower, in which case... I don't know. Maybe something's going to happen, but... Yeah, I think that's it. We pick up the win, and thankfully we did preserve the 4-0. I genuinely 100% forgot about that Arcanine. Wow, that is kind of wild. That is kind of wild. And that Arcanine could have been bad if I had put my Infernape in harm's way. But with that, thank you guys so much for watching. Yesterday, we put up the championship match for the PGLNU Cup, and it was a whole lot of fun. Please do check that out. And tomorrow, we will have week 3, I believe, of the Saffron Battle Network, and of course, more weeks of the PGBL and the Saffron Battle Network to come really, really soon, as well as the UBL, which will be starting up pretty darn soon from here. But with that, thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll be once again out.